friends, I am Angel Andre Balerao. I am studying in Poddar International School in class 8. Today, we are going to see the question and answers of the lesson The Last Leap, written by O. Henry. But before watching this video in detail, don't forget to subscribe my channel. So let's start. The question and answers. Question 1. Where did Sue and John C. stay? What was their profession? Answer is, they lived in a small flat on the fourth story of an old house. They were both artists. Question 2. Why was Sue John C. fell ill? The answer is, Sue was worried because John C. will worry when lie on her bed without moving and will just gaze out of her window all day. Even though the doctor came every day, there was no change in her condition. Question 3. What illness did John C. have? Who looked after her? The answer is, John C. was suffering from pneumonia. Her friend Sue looked after her. Question 4. What worried the doctor? The answer is, the doctor was worried because there was no improvement in John C.'s condition. He felt that John C. was not responding to treatment because she had made up her mind not to do so. He felt she had lost her will to live, and hence the medicines were not going to be useful to her. Question 5. How did Sue try to revive John C.'s interest in life? The answer is, Sue talked to her about the clothes and fashions. Then she brought her drawing board into John C.'s room and started painting. She also whistled while painting, hoping to get distracting John C.'s mind from her illness. Question 6. Why was John C. counting the leaves on the creeper outside her window? The answer is, John C. had made up her mind that the day the last leaf fell off the creeper, she will die. So, she was counting the leaves as they fell off the creeper. Question 7. Why did Sue go to Burman? The answer is, Sue went to Burman because she had to paint an old miner and she wanted him as the model for the painting. Question 8. Who was Burman? The answer is, Burman was a 60 years old painter whose only ambition was to paint a masterpiece. He lived in the same building as Sue and John C. and sometimes acted as a model for the painting. Question 9. What did Sue confide in Burman? The answer is, she told him about her worries about John C., who refused to recover from her illness because of her belief that she was going to die the day the last leaf fell off the creeper outside her window. Question 10. What did Sue feel when she saw the last leaf on the creeper? Who was at the window of her? The answer is, Sue felt extremely worried that the lid will fall off by the next morning, and if John C. saw that, she will not survive. Burman, an old painter, and her neighbor was at the window with her. Question 11. Why was Sue nervous to draw back the window curtains? The answer is, she was worried that the last leaf on the creeper might have fallen off in the window and snow the previous night, and that her friend John C. will consider it as a warning that she was also going to die soon. Question 12. How did the sight of the last leaf affected John C.? The answer is, the sight of the last leaf clinging on the creeper in spite of the wind and snow revived John C. and gave her the faith that she will survive. She realized how much she had troubled Sue by her gloom and depression, and also thought of the fact that it was a sin to want to die. Question 13. How did the doctor react to John C.'s recovery? What news did he give to Sue? The answer is, he declared that as John C.'s will to live had been revived, she would recover soon. He informed Sue that her neighbor Burman had fallen ill with pneumonia and that he did not expect him to survive. Question 14. How did Burman die? The answer is, he died of pneumonia. He had been out in the stormy night painting a leaf on the creeper outside John C.'s window. He came home soaked in the rain and fell ill there. The janitor found him there in the morning. Question 15. What did the presence of the paints and brushes near Burman's bed signify? The answer is, they signified that he had been out painting in the middle of the snowy, windy night. Question 16. Why had Berman felt the need to paint the leaf on the creeper? The answer is, John C., his neighbor who had been suffering from pneumonia, had developed a strong belief that she would die the day the last leaf of the creeper outside her window fell. Berman felt that he had to paint the leaf that night in order to save her life, as all the leaves have fallen off in the storm. Question 17. What impression do you get of Berman? The answer is, Berman appears to be a selfless, caring man who was fond of his neighbors and put their welfares before his own. He is a great painter because the leaf he painted is so realistic that no one can distinguish it from a real one. Question 18. What was Berman's masterpiece? Why was it called so? The answer is, the last leaf he painted on the creeper was his masterpiece because it was realistic that John C. did not realize that it had been painted. As a result, she recovered from her illness. Even though it was not a famous painting, it was one that saved a life and thus it was a masterpiece. Question 19. Do you think John C. was a good friend? Give reason for your answer. The answer is, either yes or no is acceptable, as long as it is supported by significant arguments. No, I don't think she was a good friend because she did not respond to the love and care showered on her by Sue. She did not respond to doctor's treatment just because she had decided in her head that she will die the day the last leaf on the creeper fell, and she ignored any attempts by her friend to help her. Yes, she was a good friend, as she did finally realize and appreciate all that Sue had done for her. She apologized and made an effort to recover, thereby showing that she cared about Sue's friendship. Question 20. What was John C.'s illness? What ultimately cured her? Medicines or her will to live? The answer is, John C. was suffering from pneumonia. She was not responding to medicines because she had no will to live. When she finally made up her mind to get better, she recovered from her illness. Question 21. Do you think the feelings of depression John C. had is common among teenagers? Give reason for your answer. The answer is yes. Feeling of depression can be common among teenagers. They are usually sheltered and protected from the ups and downs of life by their parents and children, and often find it difficult to deal with obstacles and challenges as they grow up. Question 22. Berman has a dream. What is it? Does it come true? The answer is, Berman had a dream of painting a masterpiece. It did come true when he painted the leaf on the wall on which the creeper was growing. The painting was so realistic that it helped revive John C., who had been waiting for the last leaf on the creeper to fall. Question 23. What was Berman's masterpiece? What makes you say so? The answer is, his masterpiece was the leaf that he painted on the wall next to the creeper. Sue called it his masterpiece because it was so realistic that no one realized that it had been painted. Question 24. How long had Berman been ill? Why did he die so quickly? The answer is, Berman had been ill for 2 days. He died very quickly because he had gone out in the storm and remained in his wet clothes even after he returned to his flat. He was about 60 years old and caught a chill very quickly. Further, he was found to be ill by the janitor, as he lived alone, which also suggests that he did not really have anyone to take care of him. Question 25. John C. called herself wicked. Do you agree with her? The answer is, John C. can be called wicked because she not only lost her will to live, she also ignored all the attempts by her friend Sue to help her. Even though Sue was going to great efforts to take care of her, John C. did not respond. In fact, it was because of her stubborn nature that Berman ultimately lost his life. The last leaf, extra question and answers. Long answer type. Question 1. Do you think Berman was a great artist or a great human being? Give reasons for your answer. The answer is, in my opinion, Berman was a great human being. No doubt he was a talented artist, which is evident from his painting of the last leaf on the wall. The painting was so realistic that everyone thought it was a real leaf, which saved Jhansi's life. Jhansi had made up her mind that she will die of her illness the day the last leaf fell off the creeper. However, Berman decided to help Sue, her friend, who was worried about the effect the falling of the last leaf will have on Jhansi. This shows how caring, selfless and concerned he was. He went out in the stormy and cold night to paint the leaf and he came back soaked to the skin, in no condition to even remove his wet clothes and shoes. He made up the supreme sacrifice of his life to save the life of another human being. Question 2. Compare the construct, the characters of Sue and Jhansi. The answer is, Sue and Jhansi were both artists and good friends. They shared a small flat in an old building. Sue was a very loyal and caring friend. She did everything she could to take care of Jhansi when she fell ill with pneumonia. She not only took care of Jhansi physically, but also helped her earning money by selling her paintings. She cooked and ensured that Jhansi received the best treatment. Jhansi, on the other hand, appears to have been a depressed and gloomy person who is very self-absorbed. She did not have the will to fight against her illness and did not respond to the doctor or to Sue's care and concern. She was highly imaginative, as she came to believe that her life was linked to the number of leaves on the creeper outside her window. She believed that she will die the day the last leaf of the creeper fell. It was because of his stubborn belief that Berman, an old artist, lost his life when he went out in the storm to paint a leaf onto the creeper so that Jhansi will not realize that the last leaf had actually fallen. Question 3. This story shows the power of the mind. Discuss. The answer is, yes, the story reveals the power of one's thought and the mind in making us believe in something. In this story, we see that one of the characters, Jhansi, is suffering from pneumonia. She believes that she will not survive, and as a result, even medicines have no effect on her. Even her doctor was worried about her chances of recovery. Later, we see the power of the mind once again when she recovers. At this point, her belief was that she will only live as long as the last leaf stayed on the creeper. When she sees that the leaf does not fall off despite the wind and stormy conditions, it makes her believe that even she might be able to survive. Even though it is not real leaf and was just painted by Berman, Jhansi draws inspiration from it and slowly gains the will to live. Therefore, the story clearly expresses the power of the mind in changing the course of our lives. Question 4. Why has the story been called The Last Leaf? Do you think it is appropriate? Give reasons for your answer. The answer is, as the title suggests, the story revolves around the importance of a single leaf on a tree. The leaf is particularly important in saving the life of a girl who had convinced herself that she will die the moment the last leaf fell off the tree. However, the leaf miraculously stays on the tree, giving the girl hope to survive. The title also refers to the fact that the leaf is the last artwork made by an out-of-work painter, which also becomes his masterpiece. Question 5. What is the theme and message of the story? The answer is, the story explores the idea of the impact of true art and what makes a painting a true masterpiece. It also highlights the themes of selflessness and the supreme sacrifice of self to save the life of another human being. It also explores the loyalties of a true friendship and the levels to which we can go to help a friend. The story shares a message of the power of love and friendship. It reminds us that selflessness is the highest virtue one can attain. Okay friends, I hope you like this video. If you like this video, then hit the like button, share with your friends, and if you have any suggestions for me, please write in comment box. Bye, have a good day. Thanks for watching my video.